the investigator, Tom Meyer, uncovering a startling case of fraud and deception that has cost taxpayers a small fortune.
Move on, brother.
I'm not a brother.
Well,
I'm Tom Meyer. I'm Tom Meyer.
Get out my face.
Excuse me?
You heard me. Get the out my face.
A teacher launches into a profanity-laced tirade, furious that her elaborate scheme to defraud taxpayers and the public schools is uncovered.
She tried to scam everybody.
Elizabeth Roberts has been pulling off a con game by pretending to be Charmaine Woods, a high school classmate who died in 1969, Charmaine's brother.
Why are you upset about it?
Because my sister has been dead for 34 years, and now I find out someone is using her name.
Roberts tried to continue the con, even though we produced a death certificate for Woods.
I am Charmaine Woods. I was raised
Charmaine's
by
Woods is
my,
dead.
Excuse me. I was raised by my aunt. Okay, and her name is Precious Woods. No. Well, then you get this camera out of my face if you want me to take your hands off me. And I mean it.
Roberts was fiercely determined to cover up a prior felony conviction for fear she'd be fired if the schools found out.
This is shame. This is crying shame.
How far did Roberts go to conceal her identity? A security firm thought they were taking her fingerprints for a job promotion. But 19 Action News has learned it was a mentally handicapped woman who posed as Roberts.
I think that's very pathetic. I mean, I'm sorry, that to me is just so wrong.
Roberts was making good money before and after her cover was blown, up to $52,000. But we've learned she's under criminal investigation for allegedly receiving welfare benefits at the same time she was collecting a full teacher's salary. Not bad for someone who got transferred out of four schools in 6 years. She was eventually placed in a room by herself at the administration building. What did she do all day? She reviewed papers, but no cut in pay. School officials admit taxpayers got shortchanged.
She's being paid a certain amount of money to do she's a teacher or a media specialist. She wasn't doing those jobs.
It's estimated that taxpayers spent $250,000 prosecuting Roberts. A 15-month investigation involved school, police, county, and state investigators, fingerprint experts, and elaborate charts.
We put a lot of time and a lot of effort into this.
Incredibly, taxpayers paid for Roberts' defense, even though she was making $52,000, living in a home with a satellite TV dish, and driving a newer Jeep Grand Cherokee.
I am Charmaine Woods.
Even though she's dead? Even though she's dead.
Roberts maintained her innocence despite a pile of evidence against her. She used a foul mouth and a firm grip to defend herself.
There was a man that did 10 years in jail just because of fingerprints and DNA exonerated him. So don't start the bull. Get the out my face.
Fingerprints don't lie.
That is a lie.
Have you ever seen a case like this come across your desk?
Never. Never, no. This is the first case, and I hope it's the last.
When asked if the schools and taxpayers got their money's worth for her services, Roberts had a few choice and closing words.
I still don't know what you do for the Cleveland School District.
I tell you what you can do. You can kiss my black ass.
Well, I don't think I'm going to do that.
Well, okay, then I think you better move.
Roberts might be moving on to prison. It took a jury just 1 hour to find her guilty of identity theft, tampering with records, and forgery. From the newsroom, Tom Meyer, 19 Action News.
The Cleveland school system fired Roberts. A judge will sentence her soon.